call the meeting to order. We want to welcome you here. I invite you to stand with us, and we will begin first with a word of prayer, and then we'll remain standing, please, for the pledge to the flag. We'll call on Commissioner Kyle Adams to open the meeting with prayer.
Let us pray. Dear God, thank you for this day, Lord, and just thank you for all the blessings that you give us, Lord. Just thank you for your traveling graces, Lord. Just be with us as we handle the county's business, and in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Join us for the pledge, please. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. Be seated. We do want to express our appreciation for your attendance today, your interest in the business of the county and the mission. We want to first take an opportunity to recognize the service of someone that served our county for many, many years. We're thrilled to have Coach Richard Robertson with us today. Coach, we're going to put you at the very first of the agenda, if that's okay. Coach Robertson, many of us know because he has been a longstanding member of our school education community here in Andalusia. He's been a member of our community for his entire life, actually, but a long-time member of the education system, making a difference in the lives of students, men and women, that encountered him during his career. But in addition to Coach Robertson, there was a long, long life of service by his wife, Miss Ethel. And we are thrilled today to join our community and expressing our appreciation, Coach, for the service of Mrs. Ethel as a longtime member of the board of the Department of Human Resources of Covington County. And so I'd like to ask you to come forward and encourage the commissioners to join us down front, and we'll present you with a plaque that expresses our appreciation for Ms. Ethel's service, and also for, in doing that, we want to express our thanks to you as well. We don't get this opportunity very often to tell folks how much we appreciate their service, but this is a proclamation that states, whereas Ms. Ethel Robertson of Andalusia, Alabama, served as a member of the Covington County Department of Human Resources Board for many years, having been appointed by the Covington County Commission, and whereas Mrs. Robertson capably performed the duties as a board member, serving her fellow citizens of Covington County for the better part of 2 decades in this capacity, while continuing to serve the children of our county as a faithful employee of our school systems. And whereas Mrs. Robertson was diligent in carrying out the duties and responsibilities of her appointment, now therefore be it proclaimed that we, the members of the Covington County Commission, hereby extend our personal gratitude to the family of the late Miss Ethel Robertson for her many years of distinguished service to the families and children of Covington County. And witness where we adhere to set our hands and cause this seal to be fixed this 14th day of November 2017. So we do thank you so much. So we
y'all come together. Let's get a picture when y'all stand around.
We will.
Thank you. Like you like one.
Glad you make comments if you care to. Robertson feels lost. He ought to be under in the early stages of basketball season right now. He's relaxed and calm, so glad you're doing well in retirement. We also had on our agenda today to hear from Eric Johnson. Eric, do you have comments or you want to hold those?
You do.
Okay. We'll recognize Eric Johnson at this time. Eric is operates the Point A campground and park under contract with Covenant County Commission.
Morning.
Morning.
Okay, all the work is done on all the sites. We're waiting a final inspection from the health department on the new sewer system. We had that little flare up a week or so ago about a pump. What I did was I, just to give you an update on that situation, we went ahead and bought a new pump that we're not going to include. The pump was pumping at less than 10 gallons per minute, and we had installed other high flow pumps that were in excess of 30 plus gallons a minute. So to keep from an overflow situation, we just went ahead and bought a new matching pump to the other two that we had already put in the two tanks. So we're going to finish all that up and have David Corbell come out and finish getting that wired, and then we'll have the hopefully the final inspection done either this week or the first part of next week. But what that leads us to is now we're ready to start doing the repaving on these sites, the extensions on the couple that were in there, and then the dirt work for the grade behind those sites. So I had talked to Lynn about that before, and so I just wanted everybody to know where we were at, and we're ready to move forward with some of that in-kind services for getting that stuff done.
Okay. Did we have electrical, a licensed electrician review the electrical part as well? I know that was a request.
Well, that's David Corbell, and I think what Power South was wanting to do was to get some folks from Covington Electric out there, Joey Smith, okay, or somebody to come out, which is no problem.
Okay.
I mean,
so
we can do, we can schedule that.
Okay.
Right. But I think what we should probably do is let him finish the pump work first, and then once everything's done,
all right,
then go ahead and have that meeting out there with Dusty and whoever they want from their side, and David and Joey and Kevin or whoever.
Okay. So you said work is complete. What you're referring to is the agreement that Power South that laid out seven or eight projects, estimates of cost.
Correct.
And we've accumulated the paperwork on those and reviewed those projects. And Power South has reviewed those. I know I talked to them yesterday.
Right.
And then we'll submit paperwork to them to document the completion of that.
Right.
Okay, so that'll be our next step.
Right.
And then I think you mentioned the pads and the paving that needs to be done for the whether it's concrete, asphalt, or whatever, for the parking sites.
Correct.
That have been extended.
Right.
And we'll ask to look at those and then report back to us what you see, what's involved, and let's see what our next step is from that.
Okay.
So.
Excellent.
All right. I would encourage you to hold on moving forward on them until we hear back from Lynn and the commission looks at it. And let's make sure what our next step is before we look forward.
Okay. Excellent.
Anybody else have any questions or comments for Eric?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Thank you, Eric.
You're welcome.
Good job.
Thank you.
Next on the agenda is public comments from elected officials. Any of you guys that are here, you guy that is here, you have anything you want to bring up at this time, Vince? Nothing. All right. Next is the consent agenda. We need to consider the minutes from the October 24th regular meeting, and also the accounts payable account and payroll reports that you have in your packets, page 2 through 17. So you've had a chance to review those items. Ask if there are any changes or corrections, or if there's a motion to approve.
I'll make a motion to approve.
All right.
I'll second.
So motion to approve all the items under the consent agenda, and we'll. There's a second. All in favor say aye.
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 Opposed, same sign. Okay. Thank you. There's nothing listed under old business. Any of the commissioners have anything that comes to mind that you think we need to bring up there? Okay. Item under first item under new business is considering board appointment. Page 18 in your packet. Southeast Alabama Regional Planning and Development Commission. Is it only a single seat?
It is.
So both.
So
the only, it appears that the only slot that's up for reappointment at this time until a month or two from now is the seat that's held by me. That's typically been the chairman's appointment. glad to entertain a change in that if y'all want to, or I do try to make those meetings, and appreciate the good work of the Regional Planning Commission. They're vital to our communities, so, and I'm willing to be reappointed if y'all so agree.
I'll make a motion to reappoint. Chairman White.
All right. Is there a second? Okay, second, Joe. Any other comments or thoughts on that? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Thank y'all. I'll continue to attend and serve. Next is consider solicitation of bids for a trailer. And my understanding is that we need a trailer for hauling the Ukraine drag line. And we got some estimates of cost. Nothing we can act on. We need to solicit bids at this time. An invitation for new or used?
Used. I'm just looking for anything used.
Used so trailers.
Basically, the bid we got was for a new trailer, and I'm just looking for a used.
Used trailers.
Yeah.
All right. So let's authorize Lynn to request bids, do it in a formal fashion, and see what kind of prices he can get for a used trailer. You're going to spec it so that everybody's bidding on a range of age.
Wide range, yes.
Size. Okay. Is there a motion?
I make a motion.
All right, the motion and the second from, I didn't hear who it's from.
Kenneth, now whoever. Over here.
Questions? Yeah.
Neither one.
All right, we'll split it. Comments? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. All right. We've had a request for an appropriation. I'll ask Karen to report on that to us.
Okay.
Page 19 and 20.
Okay. We had a request from Maggie Jones at the Andalusia Chamber of Commerce to help with the Veterans Day celebration that was held this past Friday. She's requesting $500. That was to help for the preparation, decoration, and coordination of that event.
Primarily, the part that the chamber does in that is related to the parade. So they build floats. The veterans and their families ride on those floats. I think they had three, maybe four this year. From my recollection, it's been a long-standing practice for us to participate with the chamber on the parade portion of that event. Is there a motion to approve the $500 appropriation?
To be made out of the contingency fund.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll make that motion.
All right.
A second.
Motion and a second. Anybody have any questions on this?
No, I think it's a good thing because we recognize our veterans and what all they've done, so I definitely think we need to acknowledge them.
There was good attendance. The parade was well attended, and the ceremony following the parade also.
I thought it had a very good speaker.
Good event, yeah. Very nice. All right, there's motion, second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Okay. Next item is a request for surplus of equipment. And Karen, do you have my name or Lynn?
Well, I spoke with Ron, but it's a Lynn, you want to go ahead with that?
Yeah, since we got some surplus, since we've purchased the wheeled excavator, and it'll be here in 2 weeks, I believe, is the estimated delivery date on that. Since we're getting at a piece of equipment, there's no need for the most of the four items you see on here, these boom cutters and the old cab over truck we have. It's just putting it up for surplus. We just don't use it.
So we're asking to declare it surplus, and we're asking to dispose of these how?
Either by gov deals or we'll put them out to bid.
Okay.
We'll try to get
so
the best offer.
Are we still going to maintain one boom cutter? Are we still going to have one at all?
We can,
do you see the need that we might have to use one
we
of
We could keep one of these.
I mean, it's up to you. I mean, I'm asking.
The wheeled excavator has a cutter on, right?
Yes.
Right.
Yeah.
But, for some smaller job, we might could maintain one. If they were keeping, I don't know the condition of them.
Yes,
they're not attached to nothing.
They're not attached. Like, so we've converted those to actually bush hog tractors right now. But we can keep one just as a spare.
No.
We still have the equipment to do that.
What is it to hook that back up?
It's about a day's worth of work to get it together.
Anyway, just a thought. If we had a small job, we might.
Joe, you want to make that as part of the
well,
motion
just leave
on
it.
This?
I'll just leave it. I'd make a motion to declare this surplus and leave it at Mr. Rawls' discretion if he wants to pull one
so
of them out or not.
Okay. So we're talking about declaring surplus of
all of
three,
them.
Four boom cutters and one cab over 18-wheel truck. with the possibility of pulling one of the motors off.
If he sees a need.
Anybody want to second that?
I'll second.
Anybody else have thoughts on what's best to do here?
Mm-hmm.
There is a motion and a second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. So then we're going to auction it off by GovDeals on this, with the possible exception of one. And next is a consider budget for a 100-year celebration. Let Ms. Karen tell us about that.
Our courthouse has reached the grand old age of 100 years old, and we wanted to celebrate that by a special event to be taking place at the courthouse, displaying photographs of the courthouse throughout the years. And with doing so, that comes some expense, and I'm asking for y'all to consider appropriating about $1,500 from the contingency fund to cover the expenses of that display.
And that's going to take place when?
The actual display will go up soon, Kevin.
1st of December.
And then the actual, on the 19th, I believe they're going to have a speaker. And I don't know the time yet. Have you been told the time?
10 a.m.
10 a.m. for a speaker to come and just go over the years of the courthouse service.
The circuit judges have kind of taken the lead on that with some of the other officials at the courthouse. And laying out a ceremony. I'm not going to announce who the speaker is. I think it's a unique opportunity, and I think it'll be well received and well attended by many members of the community. So
it's something that is open to the public.
That is correct.
It is. So the request is for $1,500 budget. They just need to know what they can move forward with and making and doing the planning, and we do need to get that underway. Somebody want to make a motion to approve $1,500 or something different?
I certainly don't have a problem with it. I'll make that motion.
Okay.
I'll second.
Motion and second. Any other questions on this from Karen?
Mm-hmm.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Okay, thank you. Next on the agenda, the reports from staff. Let me start over here. Susan?
Portion of it. The only thing I want to point out is the BOAD part of it. The plans that we have to get a volunteer organization together to help with sheltering and the needs of the county, we're still in the planning mode of that. And we have a meeting this Thursday night at 5:30 at the Baptist Association, if you can attend this Thursday at 5:30. And we're, like I said, we're just in the beginning phases of it. It's going really well, though. We have a lot of support from the community, so I'm very excited about that. The safety program part, just notice the portion that says we finally did the application for 1617, the incentive program discount. This is the report I had to send in for that, so if you wanted to look over that, I have that with me. And other than that, everything's going good. Been busy.
You mentioned assembling 100 first aid kits. Where are those?
We have most of them made up, and we've given out engineers portion of it, and we meet with the Sheriff's Department Friday for their safety meeting, and we'll pass out those.
Okay.
So they're getting out into the county employees' vehicles.
Good.
And we're training them on the contents of the first aid kit as we're doing that. So we're kind of taking our time and going over it really well with them.
Anybody else have any comments or questions related to the report?
Keep us safe. Thank you.
Thank you, Susan. Any other staff reports? Commissioner, item you want to bring up? Coach Robertson, thank you again for being with us. We appreciate you and your family and your service over the years to this community. All right. Is there a motion to adjourn? Thank you, Tom.
I'll second that.
Second by Commissioner